This is unbelievable. I've never seen anything like this before. We've seen x-rays, we've seen CT scans, but this is a 3D version of this woman.
The original CT scans Jerry made of the woman have been loaded into a piece of groundbreaking software. It allows for a virtual autopsy of the body, unlocking the secrets contained within without making a single incision.
Normally, I'm looking at sections or regions of the body, but this thing lets me see the entire body, and I can spin it and roll it and go into it and come out of it. This is a way that I have never been able to look at a body before.
With just the swipe of a screen, it can move between multiple layers of the body, digitally stripping back skin, revealing internal organs, and showing the skeleton beneath.
If we had examined her, let's say, in 2000, we would not have had the capability with the CT and the MR, and this wonderful table would not have been there.
Yeah, right. We'd have x-rays.
We'd just have plain x-rays.
Right. Typically, in an archaeological situation, you never really know how someone died, the cause and manner of death. Based on what's left is usually the skeleton, unless they have a bullet hole or an arrowhead in them. Here, we can see clearly the cause and manner of this woman's death was smallpox.
Well, the surface, you can see all these smallpox lesions on her head, on her neck, on her chest, down into her thigh area, and even down into her feet.
And then on her heel, and on the pad of her foot, and the ball of her foot.
Typically with smallpox, the rash really initiates in the mouth and the oral cavity, and so they become very sore. You have lesions inside your mouth, and then it becomes a full-blown skin lesions in a centrifugal pattern, and that means predominantly in the limbs, but also on the trunks. And quite often it was documented that they would have exceptional fever, immune response, and then a significant drop in blood pressure, which indicates some type of organ failure.
I would have only expected lesions on the surface, but if we look inside her skull, this is her brain. Now, covering the brain, there's this tissue that's very dense. It's kind of the consistency of canvas. And that's to protect the brain, and it's called the dura. And there are lesions on the dura. What makes this really unusual is that I don't think anyone has ever imaged an individual with smallpox, looked inside, and here we've got evidence that the lesions are, in fact, inside.
It's amazing. It's like we have a map of how smallpox colonize the human body. That's a first. That's a medical first.
The woman's body was so well preserved, the smallpox that killed her remains clearly visible, something Jerry and Scott wouldn't usually get to see from skeletal remains.